Hello, welcome to my channel. This is Automation Anywhere tutorial series. So this is the second video of this series. In the last video we have seen how we can get the community version and use that to do a small automation, so which is we fill sign up information in the Facebook. So today we are going to do automation in a Windows application. So here is a sample Windows application. So it's about invoicing software. So all invoice details need to be filled. So here I have an Excel which consists of around 37 invoice details. So we fill one by one like this. If I fill manually, so invoice date and create SR now. So let's be S. So this is the manual work. So if we do it for all, it will take very long time. So now we have Automation Anywhere to do this for us. So how we gonna do is, like, we start a new task. So here we use the same command which we have used in the last video, is the object cloning. So object cloning is the one of the very useful command in Automation Anywhere. So first we select this command and just click refresh to get the window name. It's invoice software. Click capture. So here we get invoice number. So first we capture. So to remember, it's like you need to click the capture button and just drag into this text box. So, and once you see the red color within this text box, then release the mouse. Okay, here we go. So we need to input, let's say we input 100. Okay, so now we have automated this part, and we also have the customer invoice amount, invoice date and credit. So let's just copy this. You also can do this from here. Just double click or drag and drop, but I prefer copy paste. So let's go here, capture. Now we capture the customer name. So name, let's say ABCD Limited. So next one is amount. So 50,000. Next one is date. Let's just put the same 22. Today's date 23 June 2019. So next one, I think it's not text box, it's radio box. So we need to click S or no, it depends on the invoice. So as of now we choose S, so we can do the no later. So here, if you see the options here, select, we need to choose select. So we have done. Next we have add. Okay, add invoice, just release it, click, it's fine. So there are some information. I prefer to close and open to get this is just a sample program created by myself, so it does not contain any logic or something. If we add the details, it will show in the grid in the below. Okay, let's save it with the name of, okay, it should be updated variable part 2 invoice entry. Okay, let's run and see. Before that, let's do some activate command. It's like, so if you want to activate this window, we can let the RPA do it for us. So here there is a command called Windows options. In that there is the one activate window. So here we choose this one. Yes, here we go. Let's see that in action. open, enter. Wow, perfect. So this is pretty good. So now what we need to do is like we need to capture the input from the Excel and we need to enter it. So this input is our manual. So before that, let's do it by using variables. So variables is used to store the information for a short period of time, maybe until this process, maybe until this task execute. So we need almost 5 variables. So starts from invoice. Okay, let me refer invoice number. Sorry, customer. Next invoice amount. Invoice date. And credit. So we specify the same values here. So if you want to assign some date or values to the variables, there is a command called variable operation. So just double click this and select the variables which you want to store the information. So let's start with invoice number, so 101, and let's copy that. So we need 5. The second one is customer. Okay, EFGH limited. Third one is invoice amount, let's say 70,000. And fourth one, invoice date. So 24th June. Okay, and we're done. Let's put 23. And credit, let's say yes, or let's say YRN. So I think everything will work fine, but before that we need to do two adjustments. The first one is we need to change the input value from direct input to the variable. So how are we gonna do it? We need to click this input box and press F2. So here's the help description. F2, then we choose the variable which we want. So for the first one is invoice number, and this is customer. We delete it and choose from the list. And third one is invoice amount. Fourth one is invoice date. And here, so this is the second thing we need to do is like here is S or no. There are two radio buttons here. So if we see S or no, so it depends on credit variable. If credit variable has the value Y, then we choose S. If it has value N, we need to choose no. So Automation Anywhere, we have if else statement which can help us to decide whether the credit variable has Y or N. So let's put variable here. There are many options, let's just focus on variable. Variable, click edit, then you'll see this box, then select this one, press F2, then we choose credit. So here operators equal to, we need to compare, is it equal to Y? So fix yes. Okay, so here if it is equal to Y, then we choose Y. If not, we need to choose no. So here there is call else, then we choose the no. So double click and capture the no radio button, select, perfect. Okay, let's see this in action. So here what we have done is we have removed the values which we have given directly, and then we used variables to store the values, and we used the variables to give the input to the input box, and also we added the conditional, like if credit is y then we choose y, if it is not y maybe n, then you should choose no, and then click add invoices and same. So before we do that, let's close it and open it. Sorry. Okay, so let's see this in action. Okay, great, we did that. So it's same as before. So now what we're gonna do is we use Excel data and we input it. So our first option is instead of variables directly have value, we capture this from first row and we do input, and second row, third row, and so on. So in Automation Anywhere, in order to work with Excel, there's few options in the Excel command. So if you see open, close, activate, get sales, set sale, and so on. So let's first open the Excel. So open spreadsheet. If you double click that, this box will appear. So here we choose the location of the file. I have saved in the desktop. So here invoice details, select. One more option we need to carefully choose is contains header. So this file has the header. So we need to mark it is, it has header. Click save. So once we open the Excel, what we need to do next? So we need to get sales. So it means that we let the RPA to Automation Anywhere to read all the sales from that Excel. So it's get all sales. Once we read all the sales, we need to loop through, I mean we should need to iterate through one by one the rows. So for that, Automation Anywhere has a command called loop. So here it is. Here there is a specific option for Excel. So let me just, yeah, each row in an Excel data set, just double click it, then just click save. Here we go. So it means that the Automation Anywhere will capture each row in Excel and will come into this loop. So once you finish the second, third, fourth row like this, so of course it will ignore the heading because we mentioned that the first row is header, so it will start from second row. So we need to loop through all the items, so I'll pull this to the last one. Okay, so let's see this in action, but before that we need to do one more thing. So here if we see the variable operation, here we mentioned the values directly, but instead of the values, we need to select the values from Excel. How are we gonna do that? If you see here, it's mentioned command, please enter your comments to loop, use Excel column variable for each row in Excel. So we can use this variable, system variable, to capture the input from the Excel data set. So let's no need to change this one. So we need invoice number, press F2, then this will appear, Excel column. Here it is, and here we need to mention the column number. So if we see our Excel, the first column, second, so total we have 5. The first column is invoice number, and second one is customer, third invoice amount, fourth trade, and fifth is credit. So the first, let's use first for invoice number because we need invoice number here. Okay, and second customer should be 2. Okay, so column 2, sorry, 2, we can copy this, 2, this is 2, third one is amount, so just paste it and change the number to to 3, and 4 is for date, 5 is for credit. Okay, that's it. Now we have changed all the inputs to Excel, so this loop will read each row in the Excel. So this represents that the column 1 to the invoice number to customer and so on. So let's see how it works. Let me close and open this one so that we could see it clearly. Okay, let's see this in action. Okay, it opens, it enters the first one, it's S, the second one. Okay, it works, the BC company, and I wanna see the note. Wow, it works. Okay, cool, so it's just moving on and it will work until it finishes the last row. So I'll just pause the video. Okay, so if we see that it has created all the invoices from the Excel, let's just double check it. The last one is from Canada. Let's see. Yes, it is. It has finished all of them. So that's it for today. I hope that this is helpful for you guys, and this is the way we use to automate the Windows applications. So this Excel just has 37 records of invoice details. Maybe in your business or in your personal things, maybe you have a lot of records or maybe a lot of columns. So it's the same logic how we use to do automation in automate this in Automation Anywhere. Hope you like the video. If you like the video, please click like button. Also subscribe to my channel. And I will be posting the next video of this series in few days. Thanks for watching. Have a good day.